My name is Dick Mukwena. My combat name is Mzwandile Keswe. So they always abbreviated as MK. It was on the 16th of 1992. We are from the rally in Orlando. One of the commander, in fact, we knew beforehand that there was going to be a people from Ghana that are going to attack people from the battle. So the information did lead. So SMK, because one of our roles was to defend our people, we were waiting for armament to get some, because we had small guns. So somebody was supposed to bring those AKs. Unfortunately, there was miscommunication during that day. So after something, because we came late, about around 4 or 5. So I went to Zone 4, there is a place called. When I come back from that place, immediately when I come from Orlando, then I went to my, I was busy listening to music. It was around past 10, and I heard the sound, funny sound of broken windows. Then you know, then I turned off the music, and I wanted, out of curiosity, I wanted to watch. And then I realized that it was war outside, because usually, you know, you don't stay with your gun, because by that time, I had to hide it outside, you see. So quickly, I had to go and fetch my gun quickly. And I didn't even ask, I just shoot. In Qatar. Then we realized that whites were also there, you see, because we could hear that people were speaking English there. And because I was, after I retaliated, I was shot with pellets, gunshot. So then I realized that there were even policemen involved. What makes me to say that is because after I was shot, around past 11, took me to hospital. Then one of my neighbors, they came after those people have retreated. Then on our way to hospital, we took another route. We realized that police, there was a heap, they call it a heap. People were, we realized that policemen were involved in taking other people in that heap. Those who put the red, they usually put the red armbands on the head. So we realized that, okay, this is was a joint venture. Policemen were involved. Then I passed there, then I went to hospital. On the hospital, I didn't stay long, because as I was an ex-MK combatant, I realized that my life was in danger. Then they took me to a hiding place around Joburg. I didn't sleep there in hospital. So that's how that day went. So it was a terrible night. And then those people, they were very, very brutal, because they also use homemade weapons. It was pellets gun, it was gun. Yes.
And how's the life after the massacre?
The life after massacre, I think there was a lot of confusion after massacre, because people want to enrich themselves about massacre. One, that issue of massacre divided us, because you don't know whom to call a victim, survivor, and what. It was confusion. Even today, people of Lubadun, they are divided when coming to the issue of massacre. There is a rap group. So we were divided. And then there were lots of sponsors. There was no thorough accountability pertaining the issue of massacre, because people like eating the money and so forth. Generally, it was Just to be honest with you, people are divided with the issue of massacre. Others they benefited, others not yet. And then the other thing that need to be clear, who's victim, who's not victim, that question was not clear to our people, you see. Because everybody says he's a victim. And to be honest with you, that day, it affected all of us. But we do differ with degree, because others were injured during that day. You see, others it was shock, question of shock, and so forth. So there was no clear stipulation.
And then, what role do you think the massacre played in the future of this country?
Yeah, this massacre, you know, though people, they despise it. But I think this massacre played a vital role in the history of this country. Because after the massacre, the international community mobilized against South Africa, the so-called Dead Force. To understand that during that day of massacre, as we know that there were negotiations for this one and so forth. So that massacre brought breakthrough during that time. That the enemy will continue the enemy to go to the negotiation. But though there is no clear recognition of that day, you know, like June 16 and others. But I think the government need to recognize that day it was indeed a turning point in our history. Yes.
And how would you like to be remembered?
Yeah, I would like to, you know, the younger generation, they know that in Bibato, there was a young man at the age of 17. I skipped the country and I sacrificed my virginity, my youthfulness, my education, and to go and fight for this country. The only thing that they can do to honor me, if they can respect this freedom, knowing that there are people who died for this freedom, I think I will rest in peace. That there are people today, they are destitute, they are marginalized, they are disgruntled because of this freedom. And in this freedom, though we are free, but it didn't come cheap. people have died for this country.
Thank you. Do you have any last words for us?
Last words?
Any other?
Okay. Well, my last words is that I think if God can help our country, there's a lot of confusion. People are starting to forget where they come from. There's a lot of corruption. And generally, there's confusion. You don't know who to trust. But I think we need to stand up and pray for God's intervention in our country. Otherwise, I'm not a prophet of doom, but we're heading for Banana Republic soon. Thanks.
Thank you.